It is slowly making sense. Walking away, coming back, standing in front of the mirror, talking to myself, crying to myself, desperately wanting someone to hold me. Amidst the cracks of my vows, a few secrets spilling here and there, I never open up. I say to myself, how does it make sense? No matter how much the book is open, you do need someone to have the enthusiasm to lead it. I have felt loved exactly 6 times in my lifetime. 3 of which I give back to my mother, one or the other. The others I assume were accidental experiences. And all the times that I loved to my fullest, but was never loved back. At tea, I hugged a tree. It didn't hug back. At 5, I tried talking to the guy on the bench in front of McDonald's. I thought he was lonely and was only making a smile. At 7, I gave my pencil and my heart to the boy who sat beside me. He only smiled at me when I passed by him. He was always with girls. At 13, I held a pup from the street in my arms, fed him every day, and everything went well until the day he disappeared. I named him Snoopy. At 16, I left my city, bottled emotions and books I've never opened in one hand. I can tell you without permission, I'm not being missed. At 19, the boy who promised me a lifetime left me in a month. At 21, I cried over a debt, and my friend kept consoling, saying, it's a fictional character, you can create a better one. I was fictional all my life. How can I recreate myself, my love? He tells me that she's beautiful. I hear him out, and I look at him keenly. He tells me that all the waves beat off his grace. It's exaggerated. We are humans. We bleed blood, right? Or maybe I'm just a little too jealous. He tells me that she has the most beautiful smile in the world. When she smiles, he tells me that everything seems to be falling into place without even doing anything. He feels just all right. I look at him and I smile, hoping that he feels better. He looks at me and he tells me that he's glad to see me happy for him. Of course. He tells me that her voice makes him weak on his knees. Her voice makes him pause anything that he's doing and look at her for a minute. But I don't know how to talk with no words at all, and my mouth with no words, my throat choked with words like, look at me, hold me, I don't want to live without you, I love you. But he's too deaf to listen, so I hear him out. He tells me that it's she who makes the meaning of love evident. It's her hand that he wants to hold for the rest of his life. I look at mine, and I touch each of them tenderly. I don't know what else to do. There's a book that I'll write, and I'll make sure I'm not the hero, but I don't get the hero.